Hello there, welcome. Let's see how to put transitions and effects with Sony Movie Studio 13. Leave us comments to improve our videos. Let's see the transitions. There are two kinds of them. The single side transitions are made with a single clip, when it has to appear or disappear. You can add them fast, enabling the fade mode and dragging the edges of a clip. This simple transition is called crossfade. If clips are text, pictures, and videos, you will simply change the opacity level. Plus, if you right-click on the transition, you will change how the crossfade curve has to develop in time. You can do this just while you are in fade mode. The other kind is the double side transition that interests transitions between two different clips. To create it, simply approach them enough. The time inside indicates the total duration. The more you overlap the clips, the more it will last. If you don't want it anymore, just put the clips far enough. You can change the curves right-clicking on it and going to fade type. You can add more creative transitions to the single side and the double side ones. On the left, you should find the transitions window if it's not closed. If you hover the transitions, you will see how they are, passing from the clip A, the starting clip, to the clip B, the final clip. One of the two clips, A or B, is a black screen, in case of single side transitions, of course. To add one, simply drag and drop it on the crossfade just created. A window called Video Event FX lets you adjust the options of such a transition. Close it to apply the settings and check the preview if all is right. In case not, you can open the previous window another time clicking on the transition symbol. Whereas, if you want to come back to the original crossfade, just right-click. Go to transition and then to change to crossfade. Let's see the effects. There are several kinds of effects that can be very different. PanCrop is used to change the zoom and the target of the project camera. Select the clip interested and click on Pan and Crop below. Or click on its symbol on the clip if it's shown big enough. In this case, the Video Event FX shows you the options for the pan and crop effect. The big letter F represents the focus. Check the preview. If you drag the rectangle, you will change the target. So the preview will show just the parts of the clips that overlap the rectangle. Double-click to place the rectangle on the center. If you approach the squares, you can enlarge or shrink the rectangle, which means to zoom in or out the clip. Always check the preview. It's more easy and clear. The last two buttons on the extreme left regulate how to scale the rectangle, if you want to fix the center or to lock the aspect ratio. If you drag your mouse within the dashed circle, you will rotate the rectangle. On the left, you can be even more precise, typing the correct values. The most important sections are the position and the rotation ones. You can make this effect animated. At the bottom you find the keyframes. By default, you always have at least one keyframe, indicating the starting point. Then, if you want to change in time to a second set of placement, zoom and rotation values, simply move the playhead where you like and change the properties. The keyframe will be automatically created, so that when you go from the first to the second keyframe, the clip is going to move in the preview. As long as the playhead is on a keyframe, you will change the properties fixed by such keyframe. To move the keyframe in time, simply drag it on the left or right. To delete it, right-click on it and go to Cut. If the timeline has just one keyframe, you will return to the effect completely static. Just close the window when you are done. All settings will be saved. If you observe better, the pan crop is just one of the possible effects you can add to your visible clips. And each one of them is a new green plugin added in a chain, always shown on top of the video event FX. For example, to add an effect, search for the video FX window and choose the one you like. Then simply drag and drop it on the clip. The video event FX will open, showing you the settings for the effect just added. This will be added on the upper chain with its full name. While the pan crop is always active, these other effects can be turned on and off, checking or unchecking the square. Select the effect and use the second icon on the right to delete it for good. The more effects you add, the longer the chain will be. Mind that the effects order may change the final appearance of the clip. To change the order, simply click and drag a plugin on the left or right. Of course, you can manage any effect clicking on the respective plugin, even the pan crop one. Close the window to apply all. You can open the video event FX window using also the Add Effects button with the clip selected or the plugin icon on the clip, if big enough. These effects can be changed in time as well. If you want to change a property in time, click on its watch icon on the right. A timeline will appear below, listing all the properties with their watch icon active. The keyframes here work exactly as seen in the pan crop effect, as long as you use the easier approach, the lanes one. Depending on the effect, you may have the watch icons or the small timeline, but they work in the same way. The last kind of effect, very different from the first ones, is the track motion, the first button from the left in any video track. So this effect is not applied on the single clip, but on all the clips inside such track. As you can see, the track motion is very similar to the pan crop effect. The difference is that the rectangle is not the camera that sets the zoom and the target, but it's the clip itself. If you drag it, you will move the clip, not the target. Always double-click to put the rectangle on the center again. If you approach its corners and drag, you will scale the clip. To rotate the clip instead, simply hover the circumference on the center and drag. You can enable or disable rotations clicking on the first button on top. The Cartesian axis shown will help you. When you move, the X and the Y axis will be colored in blue. where you rotate, the Z axis will be blue. All the buttons on top are important to edit the rectangle more easily. For example, use the prevent movement buttons to move just vertically or horizontally. Prevent scaling to scale just vertically or horizontally. There are the two buttons already seen in the pan crop effect to fix the center or the aspect ratio. You can set precise settings and values on the left, clicking on the numbers. The aim of the track motion is to make the clip move and change in time on your project. At the bottom, you find the timeline and the keyframes. They work in the same way as seen. Always check the preview to set the right movement. Remember that the small timeline in this kind of effect doesn't show the clip duration, but the main timeline duration itself. In fact, if you move the clip, its keyframes will be moved in the timeline as well. So, if you want this movement between the 5th and the 10th second of your project, place there the keyframes. You can add some shadow and glow on the contours of the clip. In the small timeline, you can choose between position, the one that rules the clip's movement, 2D shadow that applies shadow, and 2D glow. If you click on one of them, this will become blue, and it will appear more above, with all its properties. As always, as long as you don't add other keyframes, these effects will be static. If you want them to change in time, just add keyframes to the 2D shadow or the 2D glow row. All scene values for visible clips, such as text, pictures and videos. In audio clips, you just have crossfade transitions, involving not opacity, but the audio volume. Plus, you don't have any pan crop or track motion effect. You still have audio effects that you can add and edit through the green plugin button on the clip itself. Just explore the folders, add effects through Add, and then click on OK. Then simply adjust the effects using the Audio Event FX window that works exactly like the Video Event FX one. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel to get other amazing skills.